Hi friends, welcome to another edition of 180 Briefs. It's good to see you. It's good to be able to share a few moments with you. I just want to tell you how incredibly much I miss worshiping together and getting together as a family, as a church, as friends, and as believers. And through these times, I know it's difficult that we can't physically meet, but I pray that this all ends very soon so that the body of believers can get together, because there is power when we're together. As Steve has said so many times, with, like, if you think of a fire, if one of the embers is away from the fire, then it starts to diminish in its heat and its life force, it seems. But then when you bring that back into the fire, it rekindles. And that is how I feel about the body of believers. And I pray that as we continue to hopefully see this as the end of this pandemic, I pray that you remember to stay hopeful and remember to stay connected to your friends and your families, because together we're so much more a force for good as we connect with one another. And I can't wait for that time that we can worship together again and sing together and just be together. And just know that you're being prayed for, and that when I rehearse and practice singing, I'm singing and I'm thinking of you as we worship our Lord together. And our speaker this week is Pastor Elizabeth McDonald, and I can't wait to meet her in person too. I know we haven't even met her, except Steve has, and some of you, but a warm greeting to all of you from Steve and I and the family of 180, and we look forward to seeing you very soon. Again, just stay rekindled. And have you ever been on the water in a boat or a kayak or somewhere on the sea? I, for one, prefer to be closer to land, but I do like to go out on a boat every now and then with a good driver. But imagine yourself looking out at the vast lake or sea before you. You reach down and put a hand into the water and scoop it up towards you. Immediately, the water starts leaking through your fingers and until your hand is empty. That water is a person's life. From birth to death, it's always sipping through your hands until it's gone, along with all that you hold dear in this world. And yet the kingdom that Jesus speaks of, and the kingdom that I live for, is like the rest of the water in the ocean. Mankind lives for that one cup of water that slips through our fingers. But those who follow Jesus live for that endless expanse of water, the endless expanse of the ocean. Now, even after all this, or after all that you've heard about Jesus and you still don't believe he's the Messiah, I'm not here trying to convince you or anything like that. It's just that it's Jesus himself, his kindness, that is looking upon you, and he shatters all of your defenses. And in that moment, you will understand that you are completely known by God and you are completely loved by him. I pray that moment happens for you today, because love is the only way.
Hello, Hinsdale 180 Church family. This is Pastor Elizabeth here. I'm coming to you somewhere different today. I am coming to you from downtown Chicago. I decided to take a little bit of a drive and enjoy the beauty of the city, and here I am. So right behind me is the beautiful skyline, and I just thought it was really fitting for what we're going to be talking about today. So before we dive in too deep, I just want to say a word of prayer as we begin. And dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you so much for the wonderful opportunity to come and worship you together as a 180 Church family. Lord, today as we talk about your word, I just ask that we may focus on your heart, that we may focus on what you have for our hearts, and that we may absorb your word today. Thank you for all that you do. In your name, amen. So earlier this week, I was on Instagram, and as I was scrolling, for those of you who don't know, Instagram is kind of like Facebook, but it's like more artistic and things like that. And as I was scrolling through Facebook, I saw this person talking about a remodel that they were in the midst of. Now, if you've ever done a remodel before, you may know that it's kind of an onion effect. For example, once you start ripping off the layers of your remodel, you start to see more and more problems. This often came up as my dad was a roofer growing up, and so he would often say that people wouldn't understand that some things just come up. As you rip off the roof, you rip off the shingles, and you rip off the plywood and see all of the damage that had occurred down below. And often when remodeling, you see the same situation. You see that it may look okay on the exterior, but as soon as you start ripping up the floor and things like that, you start to see some of the key issues. And so this lady was talking about how in the midst of her remodel, she had seen that there was a pipe that needed to be replaced. And needless to say, the contractor came in and said, you need to rip up your entire floor in your bathroom and replace all of these pipes. In fact, the hole went out, that they kept digging so far out of the bathroom, they actually dug into their backyard as well. And so this was a really unexpected cost that they had. And so they decided, you know, because it's such a big cost, we're going to save up some money and we're going to put it towards the disaster of a bathroom remodel later on. We're going to fill up the hole and stuff like that. So here for weeks on end, they had this gigantic hole in their bathroom that they said that their kids absolutely loved because they would go and play in the dirt and things like that. But as she was talking about it, she was saying, how often in life do we have not only physical holes in our home, like holes in the bathroom, holes in the kitchen, holes in our living rooms and family rooms from remodels that have gone wrong, but how often do we also have holes within our own life that we kind of say, hey, this is a hole and a gap that I'm desperately missing for such and such a reason? And so as I was thinking about that, I was thinking, man, that is so true, especially within the last year that we have been through as a society, as a world. How many holes have we been filling, or how many voids that have we been kind of going through? For example, maybe some of your holes in your life, your gaps within the last year have been socialization. Maybe extroverts like me are just dying to be around people and maybe becoming a little bit of an introvert during the process. Maybe one of your gaps is a financial need. Maybe in the last year you have lost your income, or you have lost maybe a bonus that you were expecting or that you were hoping for. Maybe that's been a financial gap for you. Maybe the gap in the last year has been a loved one that has passed away. You know, we have all these types of different gaps in our life that leave this kind of dark hole of a sort. And so as I was thinking about this, I was reflecting on the reading that I had at the very beginning of the year. Now, at the beginning of the year, I always like to try to read through the Bible in a year, like many of you who have done or have started to do this year. And usually at the beginning, you start at the beginning of the Bible, Genesis. And this year, I decided to join a group of ladies who I actually don't know at all. I was brought into this group by my English teacher. And she was like, you would really love the camaraderie that we have in this group. We talk about some really great things. I think you would really enjoy it. So I joined this group. And let me tell you, it's been such a blessing to get so many different perspectives and thoughts from Scripture. And so as we started the year off, we started in Genesis. And of course, we've read the first chapter of Genesis. And, you know, Genesis is one of those books where especially the first few chapters where you see it and you're like, man, I know these verses by heart. Genesis 1:1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. We know this verse like the back of our hand. We say it all of the time. But as I was reading through the first two verses of Genesis, I really genuinely had to stop because I got a little teary-eyed. And I was talking to someone this morning and we were talking about how in certain times throughout scripture, we have this moment where the Holy Spirit, because we believe in a living word, the Holy Spirit works in mighty ways. And so we may read a verse that means nothing to us now, but in a few years may make us bawl like a baby. And so as I was reading Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 and 2, I started to tear up a little bit. Not because they were profound verses or anything like that, but I started to tear up a little because these verses became a poetic description of what I felt 2020 was like and what I think. Anyway, let's just read them and I think that you'll understand what I'm saying too. So it says, Genesis 1 verses 1 and 2. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. Now, as we read through these two verses, it's interesting to again say that we've read these verses time and time again. We know them by heart. We've read them multiple times. And so they really shouldn't mean anything too special to us. But what was really profound and heartfelt to me was these verses that say, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. Now, in some Bibles, it says that this earth was without form. Your Bible may say that. Mine says formless and empty. And it's interesting that in the Hebrew, this word, this phrase, without form, has a couple different meanings. For example, it also means shapeless, lifeless, desolate, and non-existent. So what it's pretty much saying here in the first two verses, specifically verse 2, it's saying that the earth was desolate. The earth was shapeless. The earth was lifeless. There was nothing in this world. There was nothing in this earth except darkness. And so I was thinking, man, I have felt that. I can relate to that. In moments where my life has felt so dark, I remember in high school, there were some really dark moments that I had in my life and where I felt non-existent and where I felt isolated, where I felt desolate from all of the people around me. And I thought, man, that what an incredible observation that it has in scripture, that the earth was dark and empty and non-existent and lifeless. And at times I too feel that way. Now we're going to keep diving in here. And in later on it says, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. Now, I really want us to take a look at this word hovering. Now, in some Bible versions, your Bible may say hovering or moved. And this word in Hebrew, again, is also specifically used in Deuteronomy 32:11, where it talks about how the eagle protects its wings, hovers over its young with its wings to protect the little ones from what they may be going through. And it's really, really beautiful to think that that same description that's used in Deuteronomy 32:11 to describe the protection that an eagle has over its young is the same word that is used here in the beginning where it says the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. The Spirit of God was protecting this empty and lifeless earth just as much as it is now. Now, kind of to wrap this all up and to kind of put things together, because I know I've been a little over the place. We talked about holes and a bathroom, and then we talked about creation and how, you know, the earth was formless and all of these things. And I want to say each of these things because in these two verses, in these beautiful, beautiful two verses that I think I've even missed a time or two, is God is saying The earth was empty. The earth was shapeless and empty and dark. And yet, despite all of that, the Spirit of God was there. The Spirit of God was hovering, was moving over the waters. Now, the reason why I think it hit me so much is because in life, I know that I have gone through times where I have had some gaps. I have had some holes that are gone that I try to fill on my own. And I know that there has been dark and lonely points in my life, and I'm sure that you can relate to that as well. And I think in my what if for today, what if in those dark and lifeless and empty moments of life, if we remembered that God not only was in here in the world before it began, in the dark and empty state in which it was, he was hovering then in our dark and empty spots. He's also hovering. He is present. He is moving. He is protecting like an eagle, like its wings. He is there. He is present. What if we started living our gap moments in life, realizing and knowing that he is hovering, that he is there, that he is present? And not only that, see, that's just the start of this whole thing. Not only that he is there and that he is present and that he is in our darkest moments, in the moments where we are without form, but the most beautiful thing about it too is that God started creating a beautiful thing. God started creating earth, this earth that I'm standing on right now, that I see waters above behind me, that I see trees. God started creating it. And so out of this dark and desolate and lifeless and non-existent world, he was not only hovering, but he started to create some beautiful, beautiful things. He started to create light. He started to create waters. He started to create vegetation. He started to create animals. He started to create birds in the sky and clouds in the sky. He started to create mankind like you and me. He created beautiful things out of dark and desolate waters. And I think that's a beautiful metaphor of what we can bring into 2021. So my what if for you today is, what if we started living our gaps and holes in our life like they're just the start, they're just the beginning, because God has great and beautiful and mighty things to create within us and around us and use us in beautiful and mighty ways. What if we just started clinging on to the fact that the Holy Spirit is hovering around us and in us every moment, and that he is wanting to use us for great and beautiful things? I know that as I started out this year, Genesis 1 and 2 are going to be something that I cling on and create as a motto and a mantra for my life. That no matter what I do, no matter where I go, no matter how dark of a hole that this earth may dig into me this year, I'm going to cling on to the fact that God is present, that God is there, and that he is creating in me and using me for good. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for all that you do. Thank you for being a God who loves. And Lord, today I ask that no matter what we may be going through, the darkness we may be going through, whatever we may be going through, that we may cling on to your Spirit and what you may have for us and using us for good. In your name, amen.